Hey friends, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you a very smoky purple glittery eye look using the newest James Charles eyeshadow palette. I think this palette is amazing. It has so many vibrant colors, which I am in love with. I love that there are a lot of matte colors. So yeah, let's get started. The first thing I always do is prime my eyelids, and my favorite eyeshadow primer is the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot. So recently I have been using the P. Louisa eyeshadow base as well, but I do have to say that I still like the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot more. I think this is just because I'm so used to like use a eyeshadow primer which is more drier, so I still will use this one. So now I'm going to use the white color from the James Charles palette, and I'm going to use this to highlight my eyebrow. This is optional, but I do feel like it makes my eyebrow lift a little bit more, so I really like how that looks. And I always do this, by the way. I always start with a matte highlighter underneath the brow. Then I applied some eyeshadow guards, which will leave me with a very sharp edge at the outer end of my eyelid, and it will pick up any eyeshadow fallout. Then I took this light pink color with a Sigma E40 brush, and I'm going to start blending this all over in my crease. I think the shade is really light, so you can't really see it. I think it's a really nice transition for like if you want to blend out the edges of your eye look a little bit more when you play with pinks. But for now, I felt it was a little bit too light, so I mixed it with that vibrant pink color to make it more obvious. So I'm just going to blend this all the way from my inner corner to my outer corner. I went back in with the shade a few times to get like most color payoff, and I just kept blending and blending until I was like satisfied with how pink it looked. I think I went back in with my brush like 4 times, but just keep building it up until you're satisfied. So now I'm taking this purple color with that same Sigma Beauty E40 brush, and I'm going to start blending this in my crease as well, but I'm trying to blend it a little bit lower so you can still see that pink like peeking right above it. So I'm focusing like mainly like straight in my crease, and then I blend it up a little bit higher so it really blends nicely into the pink. Then now I'm showing you some of the amazing comments from my recent videos. If you want your comment to be shared in my next upcoming video, make sure you leave a comment with the hashtag notification squad, and maybe you will see your comment in my next video. So now I'm going to apply some eyeliner. I went in with the Maybelline gel eyeliner, which is just like a simple gel eyeliner, and it's really affordable. That's super nice. And I'm just going to use this for all over my eyelids for like a base for the smoky eye. And this is really easy. Just apply like black all over the eyelids, then wipe your brush so there's not like that much product left anymore, and then you're going to slowly blend around the edges so you get like a very nice blended transition. But I'm also going in with black eyeshadow later on, so this doesn't have to be perfect, but you have to make sure that the edges of the black that you're applying on your eyelid is not looking too harsh. So that's why I'm doing what I'm doing right now. I'm going to kind of blend it upwards, if that makes sense, so it's not super harsh. So now I'm taking that black eyeshadow with a Morphe M507 brush, and I'm going to apply this like just on top of the edge and then blend it upwards towards the pink. So at this moment you can still see that it looks quite harsh, but don't worry, we're going in with a few more shades to make the transition look even better. But there's always this point when you're doing a smoky eye that looks really weird, but don't worry, everything will be fine at the end. Just keep blending and go back in with other shades. So now to make the transition look better, I'm going in with this dark purple color. I'm going to blend that around the edges as well. So the secret to a perfect smoky eye is basically that when you look at the previous step, when you had like the pink in the crease and the black on the eyelid, that you go in with a in-between kind of color, like a shade which is lighter than the black but darker than the pink. You apply that in between the pink and the black, and then you will get such a nicer transition. If you want, you can also go back in with the pink later on to make the transition look even better, but this is just something you have to see when you're doing this. Does it need a little bit more purple? Does it need a little bit more pink? From experience, I never do the same. I always look like, how is it looking right now? And then I decide if I go in with more pink or more purple. So now I'm going to use this gorgeous purple color all the way over my eyelid. This is such a beautiful color. I kind of expected it to be a little bit more purple, but I think because I applied it on top of a black eyeliner, the color will look a little bit more different. I think it turns out a bit more blue on the eyelid since I have a black base underneath. But I'm going in with a purple glitter on top of it to make that purple come back again. And then I went in with my finger because I feel like when it comes to shimmery eyeshadows, the best way to apply this is always using your finger. This gives so much more color payoff. So now on top of this, I'm going in with this glitter from MAC Cosmetics, which is so beautiful. I actually really love MAC glitters because they're really subtle, so they won't make your eyelid look very chunky, and the glitters are not really, like, chunky. I think that's like the right word. It's just a really subtle, pretty glitter. Now to apply this, I use the Smolder Cosmetics Glitter Glue. I will put the name in the description bar. What I also really like is the MAC Mixing Medium Gel. It's also really nice. As long as you use something which is sticky and which is clear, you don't want it to have a color, or you don't want the glue to dry like a white kind of base. You want it to be like clear, invisible. So just use something like that. So I applied this all over that purple eyeshadow, and then this is how it's looking right now. So now I'm going to remove the eyeshadow guards, and you can see it left me with a very sharp edge, which is really nice. Also, I didn't have a lot of fallout, but I haven't applied foundation yet, so it doesn't really matter. So now I'm going to use the Too Faced Hangover Primer all over my face, which is one of my favorite primers. I feel like it makes my skin look really moisturized, and it also leaves me with a very natural glow. So then for my T-zone, I'm going to use a different primer, which is the Benefit Cosmetics Professional. I'm using this on the cheeks, a little bit like around the nose area, and on top of my nose, and slightly, like a tiny amount, on my forehead as well. Then today for my foundation, I'm going to use the NARS Radiant Longwear Foundation in the shade Barcelona. So before you are going to comment like, whoa, this is way too orange, this is way too yellow. I know, normally I always use fake tan, so now this shade is way too dark. So I applied a lot of this stuff in my neck to make it look less like wrong. But I am totally aware of this. I'm going to fake tan today after filming this, so don't worry. But I really wanted to use this foundation because it's my absolute favorite one. So now I'm going to use this Shape Tape Concealer in the shade Light Medium. This is by Tarte Cosmetics. My all-time favorite concealer. I don't think there will be ever a concealer which I like more. But you know, you never know. Maybe this year there will be a few more better concealers. I have no idea. I know Morphe is going to launch a new concealer. I know Fenty has one. So we will see. But for this moment, I think Tarte Shape Tape is the best. So now I'm going to pull my hair back because I'm going to contour my forehead using also a Shape Tape concealer from Tarte. This one is in the color Rich. And I'm going to apply a few dots on my forehead. And then I'm going to blend this out using a beauty blender. So now that I'm really pale, I think this looks really weird because you can see that my hat, like the hat on my skull, is really white. And you can see that the contrast is a bit weird. So I'm not really liking how it looks today. But yeah, so now I'm going to use this to contour my jawline as well, which I think makes such a huge difference. It makes it really look defined. It makes you look like you lost a little weight. And I really need that after the holidays. I have eaten so much junk food, like, oh my god. I don't think my skin has ever been this bad. But alright, everything will be fine. I'm drinking a lot of water right now. So now I'm going to take this CoverFX powder. I'm going to set this on all the places where I use some concealer. This is actually a really nice powder. I feel like it makes my skin look really natural. It just blends really nicely into the skin. Then now it's time to finish off the eyes, and I'm taking this Barry M waterproof pencil. I'm going to use this all the way in my waterline. If you recreate this, you don't have to go for like a black pencil in your waterline. You can also use a white one or a nude pencil. You can give your own twist to it, but I wanted to go for a smoky lower lash line today. So now I'm going back in with that black eyeshadow from the James Charles palette. And I'm going to kind of press and blend this underneath the lower lash line. I wanted it to be as black as possible, so I'm applying it straight underneath it. And also a little bit on the waterline itself to kind of lock the eyeliner pencil in place. This is really easy and it makes the eyeliner pencil last so much longer. So now I blended the purple and the neon pink shade. And I'm going to like use a mixture of both shades to blend out my lower lash line using a tiny pencil brush. I think this pencil brush is by Morphe, I'm not really sure, but it's like a really nice tiny pencil brush which comes in really handy for if you want to blend out your lower lash line. and I think we're almost finished. I really like how it's looking so far, and I love the purple on the eyelid. I think it looks really glamorous. So now I'm using a little bit of the white eyeshadow and applying this in my inner corner area. You can also go for a shimmery shade if you prefer that. So now I'm going to use a little bit, eyeliner, because I am going in with some fake eyelashes, and whenever I do this, I always like to go in with some eyeliner underneath it so it will hide the lash band. So for today, I'm using these Pretty Little Thing lashes in the style Honey, which are really beautiful. They have like short and long hairs. I think it will be perfect for an eye look like this, so you can still see like what's going on the eyelid. If I will go in with really dramatic lashes, you might not see the glitters anymore. And then now I'm going to finish off the rest of my face. I'm going in with this Revolution bronzer. And I do want to mention that this was supposed to be a talk-through video, but my microphone stopped working, like what's new, so super annoying. So if you see me talking, you know it was supposed to be a video where I talked. So now I use this blush from Rimmel London in the shade Sweet Cheeks, applying this on the apples of my cheeks. And then now I'm going in with this gorgeous highlighting palette from Revolution, and I'm taking that golden color and applying this on the cheekbones. This is a really nice palette, and it's also very affordable, and the shade is just really gorgeous. So then I went in with this lip pencil from Morphe brushes, which I think is a dupe for the MAC Strip Down. And I think the Morphe lip pencil is only like $2. So I would definitely recommend to get your hands on this lip pencil, because it's really affordable and the color is beautiful. Then now I'm going in with this liquid lipstick from Natasha Denona, which is one of her new colors. This is in the shade 7, which is so incredibly beautiful. It dries to a matte texture and it's just the perfect new. I really love how it looks. And then this is the end result. I really hope you all enjoy watching today's video. This is my very first video where I used the James Charles palette. If you want me to do more videos using this palette, don't worry, I got you covered, because I will be doing a lot more. I really want to use every shade in this palette, so there will be a lot more videos coming soon. Let me know in the comments if you have this palette, if you want to get it. I would definitely recommend getting it because it's beautiful. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed, and hopefully I will see you all in my next video. Bye bye.